Welcome back to AM Live, and I'm here with the beautiful Lori Story.
Oh,
good morning. Good to have
morning,
you.
Heather.
You look beautiful because I love your bling.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you gotta have a little bling.
To the bling.
Yeah, that's right.
You have pretty beautiful crystal angels there.
Yay.
You have. Yeah.
Thank
so you're
you.
Here to talk about art, and you're promoting an event coming up tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, upstairs from this building, right above Heinen Company, is Amateur Hub, and it's the Hub Arts.
Yeah, I love that name.
Yeah. Well, I came in through Amateur Arts, and I really wanted to talk about that because arts are so important, and they just so often get cut out of our schools. So Amateur Arts has stepped in, and they created this wonderful program. They got a grant from California Arts, one of 84 that came through the state this year to do this program. And what they did was they signed up to do an after-school program in partnership with ACRA, who runs out of the Hub, which is this great big romping room up above Heinen Company here. And so they offered after school arts programs. Early.
Yeah, exactly.
For junior high kids. Mm-hmm. So it was an innovative grant that they wrote. And I came in along with a bunch of other artists. So I want to do a little shout out and honoring for these other artists. But the event itself is tomorrow night, and it's a mixer, like a social fun mixer. It'll be from 6 to 8. And our feature is this wonderful original musical play that I did with these kids.
Wonderful.
So we have 12 kids. My son, who's an 8th grader, makes 13. He's our guest musician. And and it's a really colorful, wonderful play. And artist Leslie Vasquez came in, and she had done some other classes for this program throughout the year. But she came in, and just we had a vision of what we wanted, and she's
amazing. She is amazing. Yeah.
And she got the kids, you know, right in there and helped. And so we have these two life-size giant mushrooms. They're our antagonists.
Oh, that's so cute.
And so our little girls or big girls are inside the these great big mushrooms, and then this super colorful set, and it's set in the rainbow forest. So
beautiful.
It's just super fun. And the kids came up with their characters and all these different things. And then we had a couple cast changes towards the end, you know, so a few of the kids that actually made it up didn't make it to the stage, so it was a little bit of a dance there. But it's just
a great experience for the kids.
It is.
You know, and for you guys too. But
creativity.
To express themselves and just to be uninhibited.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And especially at the junior high age, it can be
awkward.
Awkward age.
My daughter's 13. Trust me, I know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's so true. So it's a super fun play, and we'll do the play tomorrow during the mixer at about 6:30. And so I just want to make sure everybody knew about that.
Yeah.
If anybody's out there with little kids or does, for whatever reason can't make it in the evening, we're going to do our final dress rehearsal and it's open to the public at 4 tomorrow in the house. So I wanted to put that out there too.
So does it cost to get in upstairs?
Oh no, it's all free.
It's all free.
Yeah, and they'll have some nice little hors d'oeuvres and non-alcoholic beverages and stuff. It's a social, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then I also did want to plug these other artists because there will be some, it's like a display of the art that's been done over the course of the grant, which started in October and ends now in May.
Yeah.
And so some of these wonderful local artists that were part of the program were Pam Sharp, Linda Torin, Bruce Bacchanti, and I'm sorry if I say your names wrong, Edie Shembri, Ted Torin, Laura Lee Rose, Leslie Vasquez, Kate Allen, Sonia Casto, Arveda Fisher, and then the guest artist from Alaska, Ken Waldman. So it's been a great lineup of arts.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very good. That's excellent.
Yeah.
Break a leg.
Thank you.
Anything else you want to put
I have one other little event that I wanted to let people know about, completely different, but since I'm here.
Yeah.
I started a nonprofit called Creative Spirit Families, and we've been doing monthly play shops. We've been having them at the community building in Sutter Creek. And our June one is coming right up this Sunday, June 1st, and we've decided to have this one out at Lake Taboo.
Oh, fun.
And it's from 3 to 6, and we do a potluck at 5. And the play shops are designed that families can come together and share heart time. And we always have an art activity that we do with these play shops. And so we're making family flags. And these can be prayer flags or however you want to. Yeah. What do you fly? How do you fly free? What do you stand for? All that symbology, right?
Yeah.
We'll do an early solstice celebration, too, because solstice comes in June. And solstice is a time where people around the world will kind of look at their lives, you know?
Yeah.
And really, solstice just means it's the longest day of the year, the most sun, and symbolically that stands for the light shining, you know, shining. And so we take a look at our lives, but in a really playful, fun way. We usually do a little music, and so I just want to let people know about that's happening.
When is that?
That's this Sunday, June 1st.
Okay.
Big weekend this weekend.
Yeah,
lots going on.
Yeah.
But yeah. So thank you for having me and
you're always so full of
get the
energy
word out.
And everything. It's great. It's great.
Thank you.
So are you? What's your role with the what's your role within the county? Are you an artist yourself?
I am an artist.
Okay.
And I do a lot of stuff online these days, but I'm a literary artist, kind of, I guess, above all, and have a literacy program online. And then with Creative Spirit Families, I integrate the arts,
literary
arts and the musical arts. And
Have you always been into art? Is this something that's always been a passion for you?
Always. And you can find teachers that had me at Jackson Elementary and will tell you that I was having little plays and getting my playmates out on the playground. Come on, guys. Like, come on,
wonderful.
Let's do a show.
Yeah.
Right?
Now, do you ever do much with the Volcano Theater Company?
You know, I used to.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
I'm talking about this because I know they're really moving in the direction of doing more family shows.
Yeah, and children's
theater.
Like, so
children,
fun.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. No, I haven't when I was younger, I did some great plays up there. And and in fact, Chris Tebow and the Tebows, the importance of being earnest. I mean, all that kind of stuff, like, test your life, kind of, right?
Uh-huh.
That between that and Giles Turner, you know, just all the drama.
He's the institution.
Isn't he, though?
I remember when I was in high school, I went to Calaveras High School, and we had a great drama program there. And every year we go to the Ashland Shakespeare Festival.
Nice.
And I just never forget that.
No,
it was
you
just
never
impacting,
do.
You know?
And that's the thing, just getting back to this whole thing with the arts and the hub and all of it, is that the arts are so empowering. And that's really what helps shape us as people and for our society, because it's self-expression.
Mm-hmm.
And being creative, people kind of think it's like this fluff. It's not at all. It's how we problem solve, you know?
Exactly. Well, the more creatively you can think, the more you can make different types of decisions.
Absolutely.
It's tapping into that ability to not just think in the box, but to think outside the box. And that
you
need that in business. It's very practical.
It's a practical thing.
Yeah.
And then, you know, from a soul level, you know, sorry to bring up the F word, but it's how our energy flows. And if you look at little kids, they'll just be in their joy, and they'll take out the chalk, and they'll get out on the sidewalk, and the joy flows. And if we allow ourselves to do that as adults, it's right there for us.
Absolutely.
Fun is a good thing.
So come on out and have fun with us.
Yeah.
One more time, the times and all
yeah.
that.
Yeah, so tomorrow on Thursday, May 29th, we'll be having the arts mixer and social from 6 to 8 p.m. Our Rainbow Forest play is at 6:30.
Yeah.
And again, if anybody wants to just come out in the afternoon, if that's a better time for you, come on out at 4 and support our final dress rehearsal.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, it's important to have viewers,
a little audience.
It
definitely helps.
Absolutely.
That's why
they do the plays up in Volcano. They have town night, like, on Wednesday nights. So
right.
It's opening. That way you can get the butterflies and all that out.
Absolutely.
It's always good to have a little butterflies when you're performing.
It helps. It gives you the energy.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
I'm sure the kids are so excited.
And what age
I'm
group
so
are
excited.
The kids?
They are 5th through 8th grade.
5th through 8th grade. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And is this something you plan on doing more of?
You know, I'm always open to the possibilities. I know that ACRA is having a theater arts program for the summer. And I should know the guy's name, but someone else is leading that.
Yeah.
I kind of just go from project to project.
Yeah,
so
wherever you're needed.
Little bumblebee going flower.
That's right. Okay, Lori.
So,
it's great to have you on this morning.
Well,
thank you so much.
Heather.
And we're going to take a break. We'll be
okay,
right
great.
Back.
Thanks.